Mijn naam is Davy en welkom op de first English video on my channel. In this video we'll make this storage cabinet from a reclaimed lumber. So do you want to see the video? So please hit the thumbs up and let's go with the video.
In this video we're gonna make a storage cabinet in which I can put all my wood and Arduino parts. Only because it's reclaimed wood from a nearby renovation project, I must square up the wood. So the best thing here to do is to cut off a little strip of the wood on all the edges to get a nice straight line. And in the same time, I will cut everything to size with one of the sides as right angle ruler. Because the wood was glued, I first removed all the old glue residue and sent everything up to make it nice and flat. I also sew two long strips to size, which I will attach on the back plate to have a nice big glue area. But in addition to glue, I use also some screws to clamp everything nice and tightly. In addition to the sides, I also placed a strip on the top pieces so that later on we can screw on the top plates very nicely. And now it's time to place dividers for the compartments. For this, I have a number of slats where the divider board is resting on. You can do that nice and easy with a piece of scrap wood as a holder. And of course, I will use also glue and screws to clamp everything tight. Maybe it's too strong, but better safe than sorry. When everything is screwed and clamped up, I can put the side piece on the back plate. And of course, I use, indeed, glue and screws. I first secured one side of the wood with a wood clamp, and after that I have my both hands free to clamp everything nice and tight. And which everything is taken down, we can start with the most boring task, sanding. But I advise you to take your time for it. Sanding is very important. But your paint job will look better. And the last step before painting is to clean everything up and take all the style dust away. Okay, and now it's time to paint. But take your time for it. For example, I will first apply a few coats thinly, but when you apply a thick layer, you have a lot of chance of dripping. So please take your time with it. So use a few layers to get everything done. Unfortunately, I soon notice that my paint is running out. So I go to the shop and buy a new spray paint, only it's darker right now. So I finish it outside the camera on and I come back in a few moments with you. Okay, when the paint is drying, we can saw the dividers. And this is the only wood that I have bought for this product. So, it's a very cheap product for me. So you can see here, I place a bar of wood on the top, which acts as a guide for my saw blade. Only, don't forget, like me, that there's a little bit of space extra. Only be careful, lock down the saw blade and disconnect the power before doing that.
So this is the final storage area. You see I have a lot of trays in it and you can slide easy in and out. So I'm happy with it, but I have a question for you. What do you think from this English video on my channel? And I know my English is not very good, so please hit the thumbs up for my English, and I have tried to do it, so hit the thumbs up please. And I'm curious, do you have a question about this product or another product on my channel? So come to the comment section below and I will react to it. So, the last thing I will say in Dutch, it's houdoe.